6. Now at 6.
You're my family's angel now.
Two families dealing with the death of a loved one.
And tonight we are hearing from the families who lost loved ones Sunday night.
Archie Brown Jr. accidentally hit and killed a two-year-old boy, and then somebody shot and killed Brown, and in the process hit the toddler's brother as well. He also died.
A vigil just got underway at the scene. Todd Hicks is live tonight at 48th and Glendale. Todd?
Well, Mike and Courtney, yeah, that's right. It's getting underway as we speak right now. Let me step out of the way so you can get a better look of the scene that we're talking about here. Now, it's right here near Wall Park where this horrific chain of events took place tonight. Both families say they're heartbroken at the sudden loss of life.
I would tell him that I love him. And I'm glad he did the right thing.
It's the heartbreaking message Kiana Brown has for her brother, Archie Brown Jr. He was gunned down and murdered after accidentally striking two-year-old Damani Terry.
I knew that he was crying. I knew that because I know my brother. I know how my family was raised.
According to the Journal Sentinel, police are searching for Ricky Childs, who they say moments after the accident ran to get a gun, then shot and killed Brown in a fit of rage and injured his 15-year-old nephew, Rashid. He later died during surgery. Childs' family says if he did it, he needs to turn himself in.
I want justice too, because what's right is right. If you do the crime, I figure you should be able to do the time.
Childs' family calls this a freak accident that has left two families reeling in pain.
I want peace for their family. I want peace for my family. I mean, they lost one, we lost two, and we all grieving.
Brown's sister says the violence that's gripped the city over the last few days speaks volumes about where we are as a city.
If there's no unity, what happens? It's confusion, division, everything that's evil. That's what you see.
And I can tell you there's probably a good 100 or so people here. Also, Milwaukee County Sheriff and Milwaukee Police are here tonight kind of observing. Now, according to the Journal, Childs had been the getaway driver during a holdup several years back. He was on extended supervision and wasn't allowed to own a gun. We're live on Milwaukee's Northwest Side tonight. Todd Hicks, today's TMJ4.
All right, thank you, Todd. And visitation for Archie Brown Jr. is on Sunday from 3 until 7 p.m. at the New Pitts Mortuary. The actual funeral is at Monday at 11 a.m. at the Christian Faith Fellowship.